Bluetooth radiation could be as dangerous as cell phone radiation. Historically, Bluetooth radiation has received less attention than cell phone radiation. This oversight has led many experts to claim its safety based on the lack of definitive studies proving otherwise. However, recent research is changing this narrative, revealing potential health risks associated with Bluetooth EMF or electromagnetic fields. In a shocking turn of events, the National Toxicology Program announced in 2024 that it is halting its wireless radiation research after finding clear evidence of cancer in its studies. This development raises significant concerns about the safety of Bluetooth radiation and calls for a reevaluation of our exposure to this ubiquitous technology. Regulatory agencies often point to the non-ionizing nature of Bluetooth radiation as evidence of its safety. However, substantial evidence suggests otherwise. Emerging research indicates that it is not just the heating effects of microwave radiation, but also non-thermal effects that can cause biological harm. This includes disruptions to cellular processes and increased oxidative stress, which can lead to significant health risks. The official stance that radiation from Bluetooth headsets and other devices is too low to be considered dangerous is increasingly being challenged. This perspective is flawed, as microwave radiation is transmitted directly against the body for extended periods, especially with devices like Bluetooth headsets that are often used continuously throughout the day. Understanding bioelectricity and its importance. Bioelectricity is the natural electrical activity generated by cells, tissues, and organs in living organisms. This intrinsic electrical signaling is crucial for various physiological processes, including cell communication, growth, and healing. Bioelectricity operates much like a software program, guiding the behavior and development of the body's hardware, the cells and tissues. Recent research has highlighted the profound impact of bioelectricity on health. Studies have shown that bioelectric signals play a vital role in regenerative medicine, cancer treatment, and understanding developmental biology. For instance, disruptions in bioelectric patterns can lead to severe consequences such as cancer, while proper bioelectric signaling can promote tissue regeneration and healing. The impact of external EMFs on bioelectricity. While bioelectricity is essential for maintaining health, it is also highly susceptible to disruption by external electromagnetic fields, including those emitted by Bluetooth devices. EMFs can interfere with the body's natural electrical signals, potentially leading to adverse health effects. This interference can disrupt cellular processes, alter gene expression, and induce oxidative stress. Michael Levin versus Robert Becker on EMFs and biological processes. Michael Levin's perspective emphasizes the role of bioelectric signaling in scaling cellular goals to entire organisms. He focuses on intrinsic biological processes and expresses skepticism about the dangers of environmental EMFs, viewing them as unrelated to bioelectricity. This perspective, however, is flawed because it overlooks the entropic exchange of energy that sustains biological systems within their environment. Wireless technology, while revolutionizing communication, has also introduced a new form of pollution, entropic waste, that disrupts the natural electromagnetic environment. This disturbance is akin to chemical pollutants in its potential to subtly but profoundly alter ecosystems and human health. On the other side, Robert Becker highlights the health implications of man-made EMFs, suggesting a link between the altered electromagnetic environment and rising health issues, including cancer. Becker's concerns have been validated by FDA-approved medical devices that use low-intensity EMFs to treat cancer, demonstrating significant biological effects. Bluetooth devices, which emit non-ionizing microwave radiation, are widely used in modern technology. While often considered safe due to their low power levels, emerging evidence suggests that even low-intensity EMFs can disrupt bioelectric signaling. The science of entropic waste from Bluetooth devices reveals that entropic waste refers to byproducts of energy consumption that increase disorder or entropy within a system. In the realm of wireless technology, Bluetooth devices emit radio frequency, RF radiation, a form of electromagnetic energy necessary for communication, but also a source of environmental entropy. This phenomenon contributes to what is often referred to as electromagnetic smog, a type of pollution that, although invisible, can have profound effects on biological systems. Understanding Bluetooth radiation and entropic waste further, Bluetooth radiation, while enabling seamless connectivity and communication, also disperses energy in the form of RF radiation. This dispersion contributes to increased entropy in the environment, leading to a chaotic state that interferes with natural electromagnetic fields. These fields are crucial for the normal functioning of many biological processes. Just like other pollutants, this entropic waste is absorbed into living systems. It permeates our bodies and disrupts the ability of cells to communicate effectively, resulting in the loss of the natural electromagnetic state essential for cellular functions. Let's delve into the key points on Bluetooth radiation. Firstly, Bluetooth devices operate using non-ionizing radiation. This type of radiation does not have enough energy to ionize atoms or molecules, but it can still disrupt biological processes through non-thermal effects. Furthermore, the specific frequency and modulation of Bluetooth signals can interfere with bioelectric communication within the body, leading to potential health risks. Now, let's explore the impact of electromagnetic smog on biological systems. Electromagnetic smog, stemming from Bluetooth devices and other wireless technologies, creates an environment saturated with RF signals. This smog can disrupt the natural electromagnetic fields that are crucial for governing biological activities, such as cell communication and brain functions. Moreover, increased entropy in the environment leads to the degradation of information integrity within biological systems, causing what is known as biological dissonance. Recent research on Bluetooth EMF and health risks has brought to light some concerning findings. For instance, studies have shown that even low levels of exposure can disrupt the blood-brain barrier, which is essential in protecting the brain from harmful substances. This disruption can increase permeability, allowing toxins to enter the brain and potentially cause neurological damage. Further research has revealed that Bluetooth radiation can interfere with cellular signaling pathways, leading to oxidative stress and inflammation. These non-thermal effects are particularly concerning as they can occur at exposure levels far below current safety standards set by regulatory agencies. This implies that prolonged use of Bluetooth devices could pose a significant health risk, even if the devices themselves emit relatively low levels of radiation. Given the mounting evidence of potential health risks associated with Bluetooth radiation, it is prudent to apply the precautionary principle. This principle advocates for preventive action in the face of uncertainty, especially when dealing with potentially harmful environmental factors. For consumers, this means taking steps to minimize exposure to Bluetooth EMF, such as using wired headsets instead of Bluetooth ones, keeping Bluetooth devices away from the body when not in use, and limiting the duration of Bluetooth use. Bluetooth radiation is emitted from all Bluetooth headsets and technologies and is a type of wireless radio frequency, RF, also known as microwave radiation. Understanding the three classifications of Bluetooth radiation is critical to minimizing your exposure to Bluetooth devices. The distance Bluetooth devices can transmit data is determined by the transmitter's power, rated in one of three classes. Class 1 transmitters, the most powerful, emitting the highest level of Bluetooth radiation. They can transmit up to 100 meters with a peak transmission power of 100 milliwatts. Class 2 transmitters, less powerful, transmitting up to 10 meters with 2.5 milliwatts peak transmission power. Class 3 transmitters, the least powerful, emitting the lowest level of Bluetooth radiation, operating within 10 meters and having a peak transmission power of 1 milliwatt. Bluetooth devices that fit in or around the ear typically radiate at 0.23 watts per kilogram, WKG. This level is 10 to 100 times higher than the RF exposure levels shown to make the blood-brain barrier pathologically leaky, allowing toxins and toxic molecules to cross. This leaky blood-brain barrier has been reported by researchers like Salford, Person, Nitby, and Schirmacher to cause neuron death at exposure levels as low as 0.012 to 0.002 WKG. New research on Bluetooth radiation reveals a significant body of research indicating potential health risks associated with Bluetooth and cell phone level electromagnetic radiation. This includes major studies like the Interphone study, Hardell Group studies, Serinat study, U.S. National Toxicology Program, Ramazzini Institute study, Reflex Project, Bio Initiative report, and the work of researchers like Dr. Henry Lai. These studies collectively point towards increased health risks from cell phone level electromagnetic radiation and suggest the need for caution in dismissing potential risks. The shift in focus in scientific research towards bioelectric phenomena suggests a promising future for regenerative and therapeutic medicine. It emphasizes the need for continued independent research to navigate this complex landscape, especially with recent cuts in research funding. This shift could potentially lead to groundbreaking medical treatments by leveraging bioelectric signals for healing, underscoring the urgency of filling the research void left by governmental agencies. The thermal hypothesis has been a dominant perspective for a long time, suggesting that EMFs only cause biological effects if they generate enough heat to raise tissue temperatures significantly. However, the evidence presented by almost all of the studies done over the many decades, including those researched by Dr. Henry Lai, challenges this assumption. These studies demonstrate biological effects at exposure levels well below those causing significant heating. Non-thermal effects. Research has shown that EMFs can cause biological effects even at levels that do not produce a measurable increase in temperature. These effects include alterations in cellular processes, changes in gene expression, oxidative stress, and disruptions in neurological and reproductive systems. Mechanisms of action. Various proposed mechanisms may explain these non-thermal effects. These include the activation of voltage-gated calcium channels, changes in cellular signaling pathways, alterations in protein conformation and function, and direct interaction with biological molecules such as DNA. Cumulative effects. While single exposures to low levels of EMFs may not produce noticeable biological effects, repeated or chronic exposure over time could lead to cumulative effects on biological systems. This is particularly concerning given the ubiquity of wireless technologies and the increasing exposure levels experienced by individuals in modern society. Population variability. Individuals may respond differently to EMF exposure due to factors such as genetics, age, and underlying health conditions. Some people may be more susceptible to the biological effects of EMFs than others. Precautionary principle. Given the potential health implications and the uncertainty surrounding the long-term effects of EMF exposure, some experts advocate for applying the precautionary principle. Given the potential health risks, it is crucial to take steps to minimize exposure to Bluetooth radiation. Use wired alternatives. Opt for wired headsets or earphones instead of Bluetooth devices to reduce exposure. Limit usage. Time. Reduce the duration of Bluetooth device usage and take breaks to minimize continuous exposure. Maintain distance. Keep Bluetooth devices away from the body when not in use. Disable unnecessary features. Turn off Bluetooth when it is not actively needed to significantly reduce radiation exposure. Use EMF protection products. Consider using radiation blocking products, such as phone cases and shields, to mitigate exposure risks. The science of entropic waste highlights the unintended consequences of our reliance on wireless technologies like Bluetooth. The invisible pollution created by electromagnetic smog disrupts bioelectric processes, leading to potential health risks that warrant further investigation and precaution. Understanding and mitigating the impacts of Bluetooth radiation is essential for maintaining the integrity of our biological systems and overall health. The growing body of research on the effects of Bluetooth radiation and its potential disruption of bioelectric signaling underscores the need for caution and informed decision-making. Understanding the impact of external EMFs on our health is crucial in today's technology-driven world. By taking proactive measures to reduce exposure and stay informed about the latest research, we can better protect our health and well-being. In light of recent findings and the halted research by the NTP, it is clear that the safety of Bluetooth radiation warrants closer scrutiny. As our understanding of bioelectricity and EMFs evolves, so too should our approach to managing and mitigating the potential health risks associated with modern wireless technologies. By staying informed and taking proactive measures, we can better navigate the balance between technological convenience and health safety, ensuring that our use of Bluetooth devices does not come at the cost of our well-being. Please visit rfsafe.com to learn more.